Good afternoon. 3 days of solid sunshine and parts of the state are back bracing for extreme weather, this time a rain bomb. Between tomorrow and Friday, the rain will hit the Upper Hunter through Sydney, the Illawarra and South Coast. And after all the weather we've seen so far this year, the figures that they are predicting in the next few days are astonishing. Most areas will cop around 300 millimetres before the weekend, but it could be much worse. This was the warning from one of the Bureau's top hydrologists.
For Wednesday, we might see higher rainfall totals in excess of 100 millimetres. On Thursday, we may also see rainfall totals in excess of 200 to 250 millimetres. And then again on Friday, we may see higher rainfall totals in excess of 150 millimetres. The catchments are very wet and it won't take very much rainfall for us to see flash flooding or river rises. We therefore expect potentially dangerous road conditions and the potential for further landslips.
Okay, let's bring in Dean Storey, Assistant Commissioner with the SES. Assistant Commissioner, thank you for your time this afternoon. What is the level of concern about this weather event, knowing, I guess, more than anything, that we've got a lot of people setting off on Easter holidays by the end of this week?
Yeah, it is a concern. Significant rainfall is forecast for the central and southern parts of New South Wales. So we're urging the public to be aware and prepare accordingly. And this may include the need to re-evaluate or delay travel and holiday plans if heading to or through those areas that are forecast to be affected in the next few days. 100 to 200 millimetres of rainfall widespread is a significant amount. And those isolated forecasts of 300 mils plus is a concern, particularly when that soil is saturated, rivers are full, dams are at capacity. So the risk of flash flooding and riverine flooding is a lot higher, and the risk of travelling on roads through those affected areas is a concern as well.
We've heard about the response teams already being pre-deployed. How do you prepare for this weather event, knowing your teams have already been working so hard for so long already?
Yeah, the forecast impact areas is quite significant. Two-thirds of the state are currently forecast to be hit by this severe weather. So SES units are working with our emergency service partners and local communities to make people aware and to get them planning. We've pre-deployed storm and flood rescue strike teams in some of those higher-risk locations, along with extra aviation support as well.
Are you worried about a sense of fatigue that people are worried? They're sick of hearing about the rain and the floods. They're lured into a false sense of security, especially because of the blue sky at the moment.
Yeah, it has been a tough few months for the state with multiple major weather events following in quick succession. It has been nice to see some sunshine, some blue sky, but we're not out of the storm season yet. So with this forecast weather event closing in on us, it's a case of being vigilant, being aware, monitoring those local forecasts and planning accordingly. Staying out of floodwaters, never drive through floodwaters. If people are hitting the roads going to the holiday period, they need to be extra careful and reconsider their travel plans if travelling through or to those impacted areas.
I know I heard you speak earlier today at the press conference and you acknowledged this will bring a lot of distress to families and businesses who've been flooded multiple times this year, particularly around Lismore, the Northern Rivers, also the Nepean and Hawkesbury down from the Warragamba catchment. Are those areas included in this risk? And what do you say to those people?
Yeah, as I said, it's been a tough few months, particularly for the Northern Rivers and Mid-North Coast communities. The focus over the next few days is very much on the central and southern part of the state, from the Hunter south. But those communities in the north should continue to stay vigilant and monitor those local forecasts. They may get some isolated falls later in the week, but for the next few days, the key focus is on the central and southern New South Wales and the high risk from flash flooding and some riverine flooding in those areas as well.
We hope your crews stay safe and they've already been working extremely hard so far this year. Assistant Commissioner, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Well, we're learning more about the family caught up in the Blue Mountains landslip tragedy, how they were on holidays visiting from the UK when the ground beneath them gave way. James Wilson reports.
With inclement weather once again on the horizon, the National Parks and Wildlife Service have announced the closure of all walking tracks in the Blue Mountains National Park from 9 a.m. tomorrow. The decision follows the death of a 49-year-old man and his 9-year-old son killed in a landslide here at Wentworth Pass walking track yesterday afternoon. Their bodies were winched out by a helicopter this morning. A small crew of police rescue personnel trekking the 70-minute journey to the site near Red Rock Falls to assist with the operation.
My heart goes out to all the families of that tragedy. And these tragedies occur too often. So anything that we can do to keep people safe, we will.
Our understanding is that this was the holiday of a lifetime for a family, and tragedy has struck. Our hearts go out to them.
At Westmead Hospital, a 50-year-old woman and 14-year-old boy, the victim's mother and other son, remain in a critical condition, suffering head and abdominal injuries. The family of five were on a holiday from the UK when they left the Wentworth Falls picnic area yesterday afternoon. Aerial vision shows the top of a cliff face scarring the side of an escarpment, tearing down a path towards the walking track where the family were hiking. A 15-year-old girl, also part of the family, managed to move out of harm's way before making the 3-kilometre trek to safety with emergency services.
As I was going down, I saw a few families. I didn't get down to the falls. I was probably about 30 steps short. I was a bit cautious and I didn't want to go on the wet, muddy steps.
Park management have told Nine News the track was checked during a routine safety inspection in the days leading up to the incident. An official review will now take place.
Breaking news now, and a boy has been rushed to hospital with head injuries after reportedly falling from a ride at Movie World on the Gold Coast. The theme park says the child was injured on the carousel ride, which has now been closed. He's been taken to hospital in a serious but stable condition. Movie World says the incident is already under investigation. Well, the Premier has shifted the flood focus to getting children back into the classroom, announcing a $67 billion funding package on his second day of touring the Northern Rivers. Gracie Richter filed this report.
The Premier's here at Wardell Public School on his second day of his tour of the flood-affected New South Wales, announcing $67 million in funding for flood-affected schools and early education. This school is one among 20 in the Northern Rivers that has been impacted by the intense floods, five of those severely damaged.
Important work has happened to ensure that we've been able to relocate those schools in those areas that have been flood affected to get kids back in the classroom as quickly as possible.
The relocation of schools like Wardell Public, boosted by the support package to help teachers and students replace equipment and resume learning.
Entire classrooms have been wiped out. Teachers who might have had 10, 20, 30 years worth of resources are literally gone overnight.
Families will be able to access $500 grants per student to replace essential items that have been lost, from uniforms to bags and lunch boxes. It's welcomed by parents like Broadwater mum of three, Cherie Gator, whose home was on the Richmond River.
We walked back into devastation, like it went through the whole three stories. We lost everything.
She says the money will help, but it won't come near the full cost.
Any help at the moment is appreciative. As for the amount, we'll take what we can get at this stage.
Teachers will be able to access grants distributed by principals.
For teachers who have lost important teaching resources, up to $1,000, so that those teaching resources, laptops and the like, can be replaced.
$10 million will also fund trauma training and counselling services for staff. Kids still can't return to their school here and have been moved to other areas in the region. Now, parents should expect the funding by next term.